Namaskar, I'm Dr. Anshu Jindal from Jindal Hospital, Meerut. I'm a reproductive specialist and an obstetrician working here. We are going to talk about a very important topic today, recurrent pregnancy loss. As we are all aware that it affects 1 to 5% of all couples. It is a very distressing condition because the patient feels very insecure with each abortion. According to the American Society of Reproductive Medicine, it is defined as two or more clinically documented losses which need not be consecutive and does not include the biochemical pregnancies. Whereas the Royal College of Obstetrician and Gynecologists defines it as three or more losses which are consecutive and it includes the biochemical pregnancy. And there are various reasons for it, including antiphospholipid syndrome, anatomic causes, as well as genetic causes. Now male causes are also becoming common, and lifestyle as well as endocrine causes, which cause this very distressing condition. And actually it is the genetic causes which really baffle all the gynecologists. And we have none other than Dr. Mala Arora, who is a dynamic gynecologist from Faridabad, who has been an FICOG, chairperson of the ICOG in 2017, vice president of FOC'S in the year 2011, and also she has been the editor of the yearbook in 2018 to unravel her secrets of genetic causes of recurrent pregnancy loss. So let's hear what she has to say.
Good morning to all the viewers. I would like to explain to you five secrets of genetic causes of recurrent miscarriage. It is so important to keep these five secrets in mind. Number one, that we should not do karyotyping but do the CGH microarray. In times to come, you may be able to do the NGS platform analysis, which is even better. Number two, spontaneous foetal aneuploidy is a common cause of miscarriage, and only when we detect abnormality in the process of conception, we need to test the parents for balanced or Robertsonian translocation. A large chunk of your unexplained miscarriages may have a subtle genetic defect which may unfold if we do detailed genetic analysis. And lastly, sperm DNA fragmentation should be looked into because that may be carrying the genetic defect into the embryo. As you know, a large proportion of recurrent miscarriages is currently unexplained, to the tune of 40 to 50%. If we do advanced genetic testing on the products of conception on all patients that have more than two miscarriages, we will find a cause in roughly 70% of unexplained miscarriages to be of genetic origin. These genetic defects may be either aneuploidies or smaller genetic defects like single gene defects, and these are not picked up on routine karyotyping. So what are we to do if routine karyotyping is not helping us with identifying the genetic causes of recurrent miscarriages? The test that is now recommended is called Complete Genomic Hybridization, or CGH microarray. The microarray studies all chromosomes, and they are studied in a lot more detail than conventional karyotyping. Besides, the CGH test does not require live tissue. So if the patient has had a missed miscarriage for 3 to 4 weeks and her chorionic tissue is not viable, we are still able to perform the CGH microarray. The other major advantage of this test is that it does not, it reduces maternal cell contamination, which was a big problem when we did conventional karyotyping. Hence, if we are doing the CGH microarray, we will find out that many patients that have more than two miscarriages have an abnormal CGH testing on the karyotyping, on the products of conception. And this would lead us to investigate whether the parents have a balanced or a Robertsonian translocation which is being manifested, or is it just a spontaneous foetal aneuploidy. If it is a spontaneous aneuploidy, the prognosis in the next pregnancy is extremely good, and these patients have more than 80 to 90% chance of having a normal pregnancy. If the parents are discovered to be carriers, then in these cases, we need to counsel the parents and see if it is a repetitive aneuploidy in the baby, we need to then go on to using donor gametes. Another secret in RPL is that the sperm may be carrying genetic defects into the embryo, and this is quite common in men that have a high sperm DNA fragmentation index. If the sperm DNA is fragmented, it is associated with a higher rate of genetic abnormalities. Hence, correcting the DNA fragmentation index in these couples before they have their next conception may be an important step in reducing the incidence of recurrent pregnancy loss.
So you just heard Dr. Mala Arora just now. I'm sure a lot of your queries regarding the genetic cause of recurrent pregnancy loss have been clarified today. And I would just like to sum up by saying that it is the product of conception karyotyping which is very important. If it shows a euploid karyotyping, it means that the regular workup of a recurrent pregnancy loss needs to be undertaken. Whereas if it shows aneuploidy, like a trisomy, a monosomy or a polyploidy, it means that this is a sporadic event, it is unlikely to repeat itself. Whereas if the product of conception shows an unbalanced translocation in the fetus, then the parental karyotyping definitely needs to be done, because the parents could be the carrier of a balanced translocation, which is quite common. The reciprocal and the Robertsonian translocations are the commonest in the parents, and it is in these patients that you have to offer an IVF with pre-implantation genetic diagnosis, structural rearrangement, or you have to go for gamete donation. If you like this video, please click on the like button and subscribe to our Global ART Forum YouTube channel. Thank you so much.